JSC on Monday set in motion the process of recruitment of the next Chief Justice, Deputy Chief Justice and Judge of the Supreme Court. Members of the commission, save from Supreme Court Judge Smokin Wanjala, who has expressed interest in the seat, met for close to 4 hours with the sole aim of opening and verifying all applications received. Even though non-committal on the actual activity by the commission, Kobia disclosed that they dealt with documents from one applicant, but was quick to state that the process might take longer time than expected. According to Kobia, scrutiny of all persons seeking to fill vacant positions at the Supreme Court may go well beyond August. But is there a justification for this delay?
It's not about qualifications such, because there are very many people who qualify. That's why the applications have attracted the numbers that has been attracted. Okay. But I think what is important is that there is a character issue that needs to be looked at, subject to which the person needs to be to consolidate the gains, okay, and also build on and correct the mistakes, okay, and omissions that were probably prevalent during the tenure of the first Chief Justice, William Tunga.
Keen observers of activities at the Supreme Court opine that input of the public in the process is a huge factor.
The public is the possessor of information as to react to the qualification of that person. More importantly, the moral aspect to it and the experience of the public. There are maybe people out there who have experience of a certain person without which we wouldn't know if that person didn't come forth.
But it appears JSC will have to deal with vested interests from many quarters as they undertake this mandate.
What I think is important is we shouldn't forget that this is both a legal process and also a political process. A political process in the sense that certain political interests shall be served, certainly, and are involved, and also other sectarian interests, if I have to say that.
Lawyer George Keithy, however, wants serving judges of the Supreme Court to relinquish their positions to avoid conflict of interest.
The race to fill the vacant positions at the Supreme Court has officially begun, but interviews to persons who have expressed interest in these positions might be delayed, as scrutiny into their application certificates might take a little bit longer. Reporting for Channel One from the Supreme Court, my name is Eric Biegon.